Hey everybody, it's your girl April here. I am back with another video. This time I hope the lighting is great. I am really doing trial and error with these videos. I'm just gonna chit chat for a minute just to explain a few things to you guys. At this particular moment, I have looked like on Amazon and just went through YouTube, and according to the people that do great videos and that are on YouTube and Amazon, to get a good camera that's going to shoot like fantastic videos, I'm looking at spending anywhere from $600 to and up on a camera. And that's just the camera, not the software and not the lens that these people talk about. They spend like the lenses that I priced with one of the young ladies on here. Oh my God, the lens is $800. Like, I'm just not in the market for that kind of equipment just for YouTube. I'm not. That's like out of my league. So I'm just doing the best that I can with what I got. And some of the mistakes that you see don't have anything to do with money. It's just I get tired in the middle of editing and then I end up getting a little bit sloppy. But I promise you guys, from this point forward, I'm going to try not to edit videos when I'm tired, okay? I make y'all that promise. But nonetheless, I'm back with another video. This hair that I have on is the curly Peruvian frontal that I had to replace because the other one was going bald. Well, I went ahead and finished this today. I know I promised you guys I was gonna try to record it, but I didn't have the time to set up. And if I wasn't gonna give you guys great footage, then I'd just rather not do it at all. So I just didn't do it, but I got it, put me in the mood to revamp a few of my wigs, if you will. This frontal, I dyed it about 2 weeks ago, but it had some bundles of hair that went with it, and I dyed those too. I dyed them the first time and they turned out kind of auburn. And my husband was like, you need to stop there. I'm telling you, it looks good. You need to stop there. But my fast ass had to go and try to do it one more time because I wanted it to look like this. And it burnt the hair up. So the hair is gone. But the frontal, it broke off some, but it did stand up. And I was able to salvage it just to, you know, do a little layered wig with it. I mean, it broke off on the edges, but I can trim that up. And as you can see by the sheen and the softness of it, that I did bring it back to life, so I'm able to use it there. I bleached the knots, but I still need to customize it some more. I want to pluck out the line, the hairline, and just work with it. So what I'm about to do now, what you guys are about to see now, is I ended up taking apart a few wigs, so I'm gonna mix match to try to make up for the hair that I lost with that one. I took apart a few wigs and I'm going to bleach them to see if I can get them to match. Now, if at some point they're not matching, I'm not gonna push it, because I don't wanna lose, you know, hair that I paid for just trying to bleach it up to a lighter color. Most of them are already light, so I am hopeful that the first time will take. This bundle right here, I already lightened it before, so I'm hoping, you know, it feels pretty healthy and pretty soft and conditioned. So I'm just gonna keep a close eye on it while I'm not gonna like put it in the aluminum foil and let it sit for 30 minutes and then come back. I'm just gonna keep checking it every 5 or 10 minutes just to make sure that I'm not going past what it's willing to take. Because, you know, I think that's what happened with that other hair. And that hair came from Annabelle. That was some great hair. That straight hair, it was beautiful. So I do plan on getting some more hair from them. in the future because their hair was gorgeous and this closure came from them too. But nonetheless, I want you guys to stay tuned. I have talked 5 minutes, that's enough. I'm going to go ahead and get started on bleaching this hair. I got everything I need here to do a bleach job. And I also have a bottle of toner if it ends up not quite what I want. But yeah, so just stay tuned and enjoy the video. Thank you guys for watching. Another dollar. I ended up having to go back to, well, I went to Sally's, had to go back to the beauty supply store because I ran out of developer. Last night I ended up bleaching the hair 2 times and so far this is where we are, and that's still not where I want to be. I need to at least get it semi close to that frontal in order for it to look and flow and blend the way that I want it to blend. This is just an empty bucket left over from last night, and I noticed last night that I kept having to stop in the middle of trying to process this hair and make up another batch of bleach. So, a mixture. So this time, I'm just gonna make up enough to cover all of the hair, and that way I don't have to keep stopping, you know, because that's messing with my time as well. So, yeah, stay tuned if you wanna see me go in for the third time of bleaching of my hair.